One of the most fundamental pieces of logic in mathematics is that if the number n exists, then its successor, n plus 1, must also exist. This type of existence is called mathematical Platonism. It seems so obviously true that we don't give it much thought. But it is such a key part of mathematical logic that if this is wrong, then almost all of mathematics is wrong. So let's give it a bit more thought, but instead of natural numbers, let's take n to mean written numeral. As far as we know, only a finite amount of numerals have ever been written. And so there must be at least one written numeral whose successor has not been written yet. In other words, the statement is false if n means written numeral. But we assume it is true if n means natural number, because we have already assumed that all natural numbers must exist, all infinitely many of them. This begs the question, what exactly is a natural number, and in what sense does it exist? Questions like these were fiercely contested by the ancient Greek philosophers seeking the source of all knowledge. On one side of the fence, there was one of the founders of atomism, Democritus. He believed that knowledge comes from the study of physical things. On the other side of the fence, we have the founder of Platonism, Plato himself. He believed that knowledge comes from the study of metaphysical things, which are things that don't exist in the physical world. Consider the number 3 in the context of 3 apples on a table. If everything can be explained in terms of physics, then so can the number 3, and so can the brain, which might be nothing more than just a biological machine. So perhaps the number 3 can be explained in terms of the functioning of the brain. Perhaps one part of the brain counts how many apples there are, and the result could be stored somewhere else. And we might keep a note somewhere about what the data refers to. Then when our thinking process, our consciousness if you like, uses this data item, it will realise what this 3 refers to. On the other hand, perhaps the brain allows us to conceive of things in a realm beyond all physics. Maybe the concept of threeness exists outside of brains. Perhaps every group of 3 things has the property of threeness, regardless of whether or not any brains exist to perceive this threeness. So now let's consider a world where all brains or thinking machines have suddenly stopped working, and first we'll consider a written numeral that represents 3. With no thinking entities to perceive and understand the written symbol, it would just be a meaningless physical collection of atoms. It requires a thinking process to understand the symbol and to perceive the number it represents. But what about the threeness of the apples on the table? Again, let's assume there are no thinking entities. Arguably, it would just be a meaningless physical collection of atoms, because it requires a thinking process to identify the different objects and to describe them as 3 objects on a table. On the other hand, perhaps a brain is not just a physical machine limited to physical activities. I mean, what about consciousness and self-awareness? Could this be evidence that the brain is somehow working with non-physical entities? And surely if we say we can imagine something that is non-physical, then surely it must be true that we can. Or maybe both of these are mistakes. Perhaps we're just fooling ourselves into believing in non-physical things. After all, people believe in all sorts of strange things. If we imagine a creature that doesn't exist in the real world, then arguably we've just taken bits of knowledge acquired from the physical world and used them to create this new imagined creature. The image exists in the machinery of the brain, and everything can be explained in terms of real-world physics. Maybe we shouldn't worry about physical or non-physical things. Maybe all that matters is consistency. Maybe mathematical logic doesn't have to be valid in the real world. Maybe, if it's consistent, then it's valid. Yes, if mathematics was all about describing the physical world, then it would be a slave to empirical evidence. But if mathematics is allowed to be metaphysical, then knowledge will mysteriously reveal itself to us, just like magic. So who won the battle for the source of all knowledge? Was it physics? Or was it metaphysics? Well, in those days, everyone had to accept that the gods were infinite, had perfect forms, and were beyond all physics. And so there was only ever going to be one winner. So in modern times, should we accept this statement as being valid? Well, almost all of us do, and we don't give a second thought to its metaphysical nature. We are so comfortable with metaphysical existence that it underpins all formal logic. If we dared to contemplate that only physical things exist, then we might conclude that almost all of mathematics is rotten to the core. This video was brought to you by extremefanatism.com.